Hi everyone, I'm Priyanka and you're welcome to The Terrace Kitchen. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make creamy coconut cake. Let's get started. For this recipe, we need 3/4 cup milk. The milk should be at room temperature. Add 1 teaspoon white vinegar. Alternatively, you can add lemon juice. Mix and set this mixture aside for 10 minutes. Here I've got a pan. You may use a kadhai or a pressure cooker without gasket and whistle. Put some salt, place a stand and preheat at medium flame for 10 minutes. After 10 to 15 minutes, the milk will slightly curdle. Next, add 3/4 cup powdered sugar. Next, add 1/4 teaspoon coconut essence. If you do not find it, you can add pineapple essence because pineapple and coconut is a great combination. Next, add 2 tablespoon oil. Make sure you do not use extra virgin olive oil or peanut oil or mustard oil in this recipe. Use any flavorless oil. Then add 2 tablespoon butter. I'm using salted butter. Make sure that the butter is either melted or is soft. After mixing, we'll sift together the dry ingredients. So here I've got 1 cup all-purpose flour, 1 teaspoon baking powder, 1/4 teaspoon baking soda. Sift a little dry ingredients at a time and mix. Start with a whisk and later you can switch to a spatula. Make sure you just remove the batter and remove the lumps and not whisk or beat the batter because that is not required. Overbeating the batter will result in a dense and hard cake. Scrape the sides of your bowl with a spatula. To bake this cake, here I've got a 6-inch cake tin which I have lined with a parchment paper and on the sides I have applied some oil. If you do not have a parchment or butter paper, you can grease your entire mold with some oil. You can see the OTG or convection instructions on the screen, but today I'm not using my electric oven. So here I've got my gas oven, a homemade oven setup. Bake the cake at medium flame for 10 minutes, 10 to 12 minutes, and then lower the flame and bake for 35 to 40 minutes. After that, you can insert a toothpick or a knife. If it comes out clean, that means your cake is done. If it doesn't, bake it for a little longer duration. Make sure you do not overbake your cake. Overbaking will result in a dry and hard cake. Cover your cake with a cloth, preferably cotton, and let it cool down. To frost the cake, here I've got approximately 3/4 cup whipping cream. I'm using non-dairy whipping cream which is already sweetened. After whipping the cream to get stiff peaks, next I'm adding coconut milk powder. This is not dry coconut powder or desiccated coconut. This is coconut milk powder. This powder can be used for curry, so if mixed with hot water, you get coconut milk. So I'm not extracting fresh coconut milk from any coconut because that would make the whipped cream runny. That's why I'm using this coconut milk powder. You can remove the cake from the tin once it becomes warm or you can let it cool down. I'm leveling the cake first, then I'm going to divide it into 3 layers. If you're not comfortable dividing your cake into 3 layers, you can just divide it into 2 layers. Use a serrated knife or a bread knife to cut your cake easily or use a sharp knife. I am placing one layer directly on my turntable, but if you are not comfortable transferring your cake later on a board, you can first place your cake on the board and decorate it on the board itself. After sugar syrup, I am applying whipped cream, coconut flavored whipped cream, and finally topping it with some grated fresh coconut. Next goes the next layer of the cake, and the steps are the same. You need to pour some sugar syrup, then whipped cream, then grated fresh coconut. Once you are done placing all the layers of the cake, cover the entire cake with whipped cream. Initially, you will have to add more whipped cream. Later, you can scrape your extra whipped cream using an offset spatula or a scraper. You can decorate the cake the way you want. Like I said, if you're comfortable transferring your cake from your turntable to a board or a plate, then you can do it. Otherwise, you can directly place your cake on a board or a plate and decorate it there. I've added some red gel food color to the remaining cream and I'm going to make a very simple design. So here I've got my butter knife. So you can use a butter knife or a spoon or anything similar to make this design. It's very easy to make. Gentle strokes of pink colored coconut flavored whipped cream. And finally, I'm adding some desiccated coconut on the top. You can also pipe some whipped cream using your favorite nozzle. If you like coconut flavored cakes, cookies, chocolates, anything, then you would definitely love this. And use coconut milk powder because that is going to add a very nice coconut flavor to your cake. The cake is moist, soft and spongy. And yes, it's eggless. If you like this recipe, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to Terrace Kitchen for more such wonderful recipes. Give this recipe a try and enjoy!